This video demonstrates the onboarding wizard in Microsoft Defender ATP, which simplifies how you get clients on board, plus how to onboard clients by using Microsoft Intune. You can onboard any version of Windows that Microsoft Defender ATP supports. However, you must have a Windows 10 Enterprise E5 or Microsoft 365 Enterprise E5 license. You can also onboard devices running macOS, Linux, iOS, and Android. That support is provided by Microsoft partners like Bitdefender, Lookout, SentinelOne, and Ziften. Check their documentation to see which versions and distributions they support. While you can onboard all these, this video focuses on Windows 10. Next up, I'll describe additional requirements for Windows 10. Microsoft Defender ATP has some requirements Windows 10 devices need to meet. Most of them are easy, since you'd have to go out of your way not to meet them. Regardless, here they are, just in case. First, Microsoft Defender ATP requires the DiagTrack service to be running in order to report cyber data. That's the default Windows configuration, so just double check that you haven't turned it off. Of course, Microsoft Defender ATP requires an internet connection. Its sensor can use about 5 megabytes each day to talk to the cloud service, plus additional bandwidth for files and investigation packages, which are sent only if you request them. Last, even if Windows Defender Antivirus isn't the primary anti-malware product, Microsoft Defender ATP relies on its passive mode to scan and provide information about files. Windows Defender Antivirus does not conflict with third-party antivirus products, so ensure no policy or script disables it. Most will meet these requirements with no effort. Onboarding clients to Microsoft Defender ATP is only slightly more time-consuming. Next. There are various ways to onboard clients to Microsoft Defender ATP, depending on the operating system and deployment method. The onboarding wizard guides you through the process by providing package files and instructions. In this example, I'm onboarding Windows 10 devices, and since we use System Center Configuration Manager, I'll choose that and then download the package file. The wizard also provides a link to deployment instructions for the downloaded package file. In most cases, those instructions are quite simple. Extracting the zip file reveals the configuration profile required to create a Microsoft Defender ATP policy in Configuration Manager. The only thing easier might be onboarding Windows 10 devices by using Microsoft Intune. You learn about that in the next segment. Connecting Microsoft Defender ATP and Microsoft Intune enables scenarios like conditional access based on threat levels, and it also streamlines the onboarding process. Since you don't have to manually upload an onboarding package, you turn on that connection in both places. First, enable the Microsoft Intune connection in Microsoft Defender Security Center settings. Second, turn on the Microsoft Defender ATP connection in Microsoft Intune. That control is in Device Compliance, Microsoft Defender ATP. Once you've connected Microsoft Defender ATP and Microsoft Intune, create a device configuration profile for Windows 10 or later that's based on the Microsoft Defender ATP profile type. There are only two settings to configure here, since Microsoft Defender ATP automatically provides the onboarding package. In this example, I'll enable both. Save my settings, and create the policy. Then, assign the profile to the devices you want to target. In my example, that'll be all devices. Once you've deployed the device configuration profile, monitoring uptake is easy. The Microsoft Defender ATP compliance chart indicates how many devices have the agent and how many do not. This chart is in Device Compliance under Microsoft Defender ATP.